The kingdom of God can be compared to a little girl looking up at the sky at night, staring at the stars, and asking deep questions about God. Does God get old? Can God be measured? Does God ever change? Suddenly, a firefly appears, an insect that can glow in the dark as it flies. It comes near to her and lands on her arm. Then the firefly looks up at her. It seems to be staring at her, as if it too is asking deep questions in its own mind about the little girl. Finally, it flies away, and now the little girl understands. Just as it is impossible for that little firefly, in his little insect mind, to really understand deep questions about her, so too it is also impossible for her, in her little human mind, to really understand deep questions about God. The point is this. The Bible teaches us that God is eternal, without measure, and unchanging. You see, the reality that we live in is made up of time, space, and matter. But those three things were created by God, so He is outside of them and not limited by them. He created time, He created space, and He created matter. So God is beyond time. He's outside of it, not limited by it. And so we say, God is eternal. God is without measure, which means He's beyond space. He's outside of space. He's not limited by space. And so we say God is without measure. And God is also unchanging. In other words, He is outside of matter. Matter can change. He's beyond it. He's not limited by it. He is spirit. God is unchanging. Now, you might be saying to yourself, well, gosh, what does that mean? How can we understand Him? Well, that's the point. The Bible teaches us that God is awesome. He is awesome, and in many ways, we cannot understand Him. We are to regard Him as being wholly other, totally an awesome God. But does God understand us? Yes, He does. The Bible says that God came to us to be with us through Jesus Christ. Jesus is Emmanuel, which means God with us. So He understands us. But why did He do that? Because He wants to have a relationship with me, and He wants to have a relationship with you.
Hey, how you doing? Officer Do-Good here, and this here's my dog, Shep. That's right. Listen, you might be wondering, why am I holding this piece of paper? Well, this piece of paper, I drew a picture of a clock. That's right, a clock. A clock reminds us that God is eternal. He's beyond time. I'm a terrible artist. Well, no, this is just a drawing. It's just to help people understand what I'm trying to say here. God is eternal. He's beyond time. That's why the clock. The Bible also tells us that God is beyond space. In other words, He's bigger than the universe, and we can't even understand it. It makes our head want to explode. In other words, let me give you an example. You see this piece of paper here? All right. Well, if we pretend for a minute that the Earth was on one end and the Sun was on the other end, the Sun is a star, by the way. If we pretend the Earth is over here and the Sun is over there, and we say to ourselves, how long would it take for us to get to the next star? It would be 40 miles away. That's how far away it would be. That's right. Now, how many people in New York? 8 million. Thank you. Well, if you can imagine that in the universe, there's a lots of stars. In our galaxy, which is the bunch of stars we live in, there's 100 billion, not 8 million, but 100 billion stars. That's just in our cluster, in our galaxy. And as far as we know, there's 100 billion galaxies. Yeah, your head's gonna explode. Well, that's what I said. God is awesome. God is beyond space. He's also beyond measure. He's also unchanging. He doesn't change. Like this piece of paper here, well, it can change, like here. There, I just changed the piece of paper. What? Why did I ruin the beautiful piece of paper? I thought you said it was terrible. You wanted to hang it in your doghouse? Yeah, well, you know what? You can have it if you want. Here. There you go. This is Officer Do-Good saying, God is awesome. God is amazing. He's wonderful. We serve an awesome God.